And thank you, RPD, for being here, Chief Lieutenant, Board, on Saturday morning, together with facilitator Judy Nelson. What we're doing this morning is brainstorming how we might manage space needs for the police department. And so this is a workshop of the Select Board with our invited guest, the RPD. Now, because we are the Select Board, everything that we do is public, so that's why you are here and welcome to be here. But it's not open for public participation, at least at this beginning piece. Certainly, near the end of the meeting, we will open up for questions and comments, and then maybe some other strategic points along the way where it seems like it's interesting and useful to do that. So that's how we're going to manage it today. And without further ado, I will introduce Judy Nelson, who is going to be our facilitator this morning.
Okay, so just a few quick ground rules for everybody. My job is to keep everybody on task, on time, making sure we meet our goals for this meeting. And so it's going to run something like this. We're going to begin by setting our goals for this meeting. And then, depending on how many there are, we will prioritize them, at which point, after which we will go into brainstorming on goal number one, discussing and prioritizing goal number one, and then repeating as necessary for further goals down the line, based on our time frame, among other things. And then, at a certain point, we will really pretty much sort of stop where we are, because we're going to run no more than 2 hours. We're going to be done by 11 at the latest. We will identify, make sure there's time at the end to identify the next steps and actions, and to identify the responsible parties for those next steps and actions, as well as what's expected to be delivered for those next steps. So that's basically how it's going to run this morning. The general rules of brainstorming are, of course, in the beginning when we start to brainstorm, it's not a discussion time. It's time to get ideas out as quickly as possible. I'll try to set those things as we go forward, as we need to. So the first step is to set our goals for this meeting. So please feel free to start talking about your goals for this meeting. A question, Suzanne? Or?
No, I was going to.
Okay. I am not the teacher in the room. So I would expect you all, I'm not going to necessarily call on people unless it's necessary. But,
well, I think you've set them out. I mean, what you've said is what I am hoping for. So we have a list of ideas, and from those ideas, we're going to pick, whether we put them absolute all in priority order, in sequential order, or just identify three or four. But somehow at the end, we've got some small number of ideas that seem viable for us to work on. And we're quite sure that's not being true.
I put up two, so not even bleeding through this one.
Thank you.
What about the establishment of a building or space needs committee comprised of Select Board, police, and townsfolks of various trades?
Mm-hmm. Same goals that we discussed on Monday night.
Those two are the same we've already discussed.
And looking at the options that are available to us, one is, you know, another complete renovation downstairs to include inside and outside, or looking at another location in town.
I think those are the things we're going to do with brainstorming, Bob. I mean, we're going to list all of the, what are some of the, where could we put something? What would we do?
So by the end of this morning, we want to make sure we have ideas for the for space needs, establish a space needs committee, and identify options. Nothing else we want to accomplish this morning.
Options and brainstorming.
Those are three very lofty goals, so I mean, I'm not encouraging more of this.
That sounds good.
Options and ideas look to be the same. The only other thing they didn't make it there was the sort of coming out, you know, here was this big of ideas. Mm-hmm. We need to prioritize or set up a list. I mean, we've set it, I just don't see it there. You know,
come up with a...
So for options, just say identify options and prioritize?
Yeah, I would like to see at the end, three or four ideas that, or two, one or two, or whatever. Because I don't know how this is going to go, but...
Okay, so option one is Summer Street.
I don't think we've started yet, we're still trying to get our goals.
Can we set a timeline to complete some of these goals?
Sounds to me like we're ready to sort of jump into the brainstorm, because it sounds like for people really want to go to. So just to make sure, so identifying options and ideas are pretty much the same thing, I've heard people say. Is there agreement on everyone there? So that's probably how would you want to rank that one? Well, that's what we can't cobble until we have them. So that's probably number one. So we'll start with that and see where we go. All right. So we're going to start with ideas and options. And at this point, feel free to just start throwing them out.
Well, when you talk about ideas for space needs, are you looking at the current facility space-wise? Because what we've done, we've actually measured every room, and we've decided which rooms can be small and which ones should maybe be a little bit larger. So maybe when we're looking at space needs, first establish what the police department needs. And then from there...
Well, I'm not sure that we're at that level of detail. Okay. I think what we're looking for is what are some options available to us to relocate or fix or whatever, renovate. We're not going to, I don't think we're down to the how many rooms.
Many cities, okay.
Yeah.
So we're going to build a new facility on Silver Street, regardless of how what it looks like. Renovate downstairs is another option.
There's a lot on Rollins Road, Rollins and Summersworth Road.
Is that the town home?
No, not right now. There's the post office across the street. We're not.
Brainstorming is a time to go a little bit crazy. If you could do anything you wanted to, this is the time to get it up there to see if it flies. And discussion will follow. This is not a time to question each other.
For existing space renovate, I mean, I think I'm looking for something that says, you know, relook all of the town hall building. In other words, you know, there's space up there, there's space down there, so, you know, rethinking town hall. And I would add to that the possibility of buying the lot next door.
The red building here?
Red building.
Yeah, because the blue one sold and
we lost that one. We tried, but we lost that one. Red building next door.
I said buy a
button
called
buy a button.
There's Turcotte
Field. I just found
one. Who owns where the Redmond building used to be? Or Water Street, the Redmond building? It used to be the Redmond Club.
Oh, the Sportsman's Club. Is that
the Redmond.
I guess I don't know where we are.
By where's down St. Hilaire's.
Oh, I thought you didn't want to be on the
other
side.
Used to be out there.
It's just an idea. What's it called again?
Oh, it used to be the Redmond Club.
Social Club.
Redmond Club.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one time the town took it over for taxes and had the building torn down.
Property. Yeah. There's the the Nesman Field. It was, like that land, you know, part of engineer, well, that's what it was all about, so. Remember when we had that 10-acre lot, Sam?
Conne?
Conne. I don't know if that might still be there, but, on Roberts Road, Conne.
During town own property on Portland Road.
We'll know what it is.
Meekins.
It was added on to the fire station.
Yeah.
Safety complex.
The cemetery.
Dodge Farm. Where is Sandy Hill? And, I mean.
Sandy Bank?
Sandy Bank. So let's put that there, I know. Sandy Bank.
It's a gully.
Gully, okay. Somebody keeps telling me there was a baseball field there one time.
There was at one point, yes. It's off of Locust Street, between Locust and Farm, because you have to go down the hill and.
Well, let's put it down, let's see how, see, makes the cut, makes the cut.
What's it called, Sandy Bank?
Sandy Bank.
Sandy Banks.
Banks, yes.
That's a blue color.
Oh, my lord.
You run the transfer station, you have a property down there.
You can put it there.
I don't believe so. Just to think of that.
I don't know the way to do a Jericho. I know Jericho owns it, but they have all that whole thing.
Yeah, well, great for them.
It'd be worth asking, hey, would you like to sell off a couple acres? What would you have to make it a bit feasible?
Yeah, no, it's a good idea.
They resell it just now.
Take it to apartment complexes next to your house, drive it to a home.
Do you want that on there? All right, so it seems like people are running out of steam. Pretty good list there. So the next part is basically a discussion and the determination of which of these are viable and which ones you want to go forward with. So I'm just going to open it up for you guys to start a discussion and a viability. And unless you'd rather take the time to prioritize what's up there right now, maybe that's the best thing to do so that we can knock some off right away. Is it helpful for us to, for us, the participants, to just say, you know how I like my dots, I don't see dots, but the top, each of us are top three, and that way if.
Works for me. So to
me. Enough to do.
To me, the three most viable are the Silver Street, the new facility on Silver Street.
Please choose your color, sir.
You want me?
I will choose.
Not that it matters. All right. So this is, I don't know how many of you have done this before, but basically you have, basically you have three votes, or we could say, let's say three votes each. You can decide now what is your priority. For instance, if you really like one priority, you could put all three dots next to that one.
if you wanted to. And then you have no more left to vote for anything else. Understood? So you could vote with as few as one or as many as three for each one, but no more than three in total.
Can you give us a couple of minutes on
that? Yeah, oh yeah, and give that now would it happen? Is there any clarification that's needed before you do that?
You want to go. Not sure.
left if they fit.
You know what number if one does? If one does.
Unless you can get the chief to sell you one of his. Tickets to a Red Sox game?
Well, I think it's a no-brainer, given the way I want to go.
And just to make sure that we don't eliminate something that you all don't want eliminated, we're not going to do another round of three dots to the right, which are the ones that you don't want to see eliminated forever. Things that sound intriguing that may need to be pursued. So again, three dots to the ones that you don't want to see, that have no dots next to them at this point.
Oh, that have no dots.
That have no dots next to them at this point. Set, that's okay too. We'll take another second to figure that out.
Good.
All right. So we have, counting dots, we have Silver Street. Summersworth Road is number two. Existing space renovate.
Person who suggested it to expound on it a little bit.
I think it's up to you to have the discussion, and I will, you know.
Well, Chief, I mean.
One moment, throw on the Silver Street.
Yeah, we'll have some discussions on it.
to give you a little history, back in the early 1970s, that's all, the town was looking at building a new police, fire, and town hall. And the Silver Street property was chosen for the building. And I have the plans here for if you folks want to take a look at it. I don't know why it didn't work out, but instead what happened was, is in the early 1970s, the highway department went to Silver Street. The fire department went from the basement from the current town hall to Roberts Road. Mm-hmm. And the police department went from the basement of the town hall to the room across the hallway over here. So in the early 70s, they got a new highway department, a new fire department, and they renovated the town hall. So that's where we've come full circle back now around to the Silver Street property. The Silver Street property is a little over an acre. It's about 1.1 acres in size. The lieutenant and I actually went out and measured it from fence line to fence line. And it's 177 feet square with the current fence line. And it looks like there's probably another 20 to 25 feet on either side of the fence line before you get to the neighbor's property. From the fence line, from the rear fence line to the large gully behind the building, you have approximately 50 feet. And from the front fence line to Silver Street, you have approximately 25 feet. So that property is well suited to fit an existing building. The size of that building, if memory serves me correctly, was 166 feet long by 60 feet. In the day.
What's the square? What is that square foot?
166
feet long.
Yeah. So, let's see.
Okay.
166 times 60. That was a 9,960 square foot building that would have set on that property back in the early 70s. It's level, the town owns it. It doesn't, you know, we don't have to purchase land. The location on Silver Street is more simply located in the entire town as opposed to being on one end of the town or another.
It seems to me too that when we had Banwell here and they provided their initial assessment, I think they were at that time listing something over 8,000 square feet for a typical police station. So you just said more than satisfies that need, right?
Right.
I mean, I don't know if that. Do you agree with that? Or
I don't need an 8,000 square foot building. I know that, but the building that we're looking at, Prosen, will fit on that space,
yeah,
with adequate parking for all. So.
And what occurs to me when I think about Silver Street, and it may not be true, you know, based on what you just said, but I worry about its ability to grow as if the town grows. Do you know what I mean? If, you know, there are always new things we have to do. You know, so is there, you know, how do you think about growth?
The building has what I've done is the building is designed so that in the rear, hopefully we'll be able to put a four-bay garage.
Is this the building?
No, that's this 1971.
Okay.
Plan. I can give this to you if you want to look at that. This is just a rough sketch from the folks who just completed the Farmington Police and Fire building. So the building designed so that 20 years
so these
from now.
So this is a preliminary?
Right, just preliminary.
Preliminary, okay.
The building is designed so that if the police department needs future space, you can always work your way back towards the existing garages attached to the building, and there still should be sufficient room on the back lot if at some point you have to build a detached 1-4 bay garage.
So how am I looking?
So there is room for
the road?
Yes, the bottom is the Silver Street section. Or the front of the building, I should say.
And the cruisers would be garage.
Finally.
The cruisers would be garage. Wow.
Don't have to scrape the ice in the snow.
Wow.
Isn't
that lovely?
And it gives you 3 rooms that you're supposed to meet all the new codes.
That meets all the new codes, CJ's requirements, everything.
Okay.
Can we add as a potential concern that looks like it's been addressed is the growth did you get that? Growth potential. Thank you. Okay.
Chief, are there any rules about being two-story, anything above you as a police station, things like that?
Well, when you start dealing with multiple floors, then you have to worry about the ADA issues. Elevators, lifts, things like that.
Jimmy, I'm going to ask a process question. So, all right, this option got a lot of dots, A. We've got some plans here. Is it, can we at least, for those of us who champion some of these other things, go through them now and...
This is a time for you to discuss, the whole list there.
I mean, there's some obvious attractive options with Silver Street. Do you have just, I know we're not there, did you have any idea, did you get a ballpark?
I did.
You're not willing to say?
Not this point.
Okay, fair enough.
Well, the reason I say it because this is I told you was the ICF building, insulated cement form building. So it's a completely cement building. I've also reached out to three modular companies to give us an estimate as well. And I just heard back from one this morning. He hasn't given me a cost as of yet, but he has thrown together a drawing for us. Traditionally, I think modular is less expensive than the ICF building. But the ICF building is a little more, certainly a lot stronger. It's more fireproof.
Mm-hmm.
It's insect, it's mold-proof as far as the walls are concerned because it's just a solid cement wall. Bullet-resistant, things like that. So it will probably last a lot longer than a 2x8 or 2x10 stick-built building.
Can we add something? I just remembered something about the Silver Street location. That is, we are currently having, we're participating in the Brownfields project, and it is being looked at and assessed as part of Brownfields. And I know we had a phase one report, and I've seen some stuff going around that they're close to providing either a final report or a phase two report. And I know either the EPA or the DES has responded. And there are some questions. It looked like there were potential questions about the site that would, I don't know this, I'm just saying, would likely be more problematic if we were trying to sell it as a residential unit than if we were trying to use it ourselves for a structure that nobody was actually living in. So, and I don't know, I haven't seen the final, we haven't seen the final, and but it is being looked at, so that's something we should keep in mind. I'll talk about, I'm happy to go back and forth. I'm ready to talk a little bit about existing space and renovating. What I see as the overarching problem with this space is the lack of parking. Which is why I put the post office, only because it gave us some, either the post office or that building there, because it, for me, just doesn't seem possible to spend the money and end up still with no place for people to park when they come here, voting. The parking is really difficult, and the traffic pattern associated with parking is difficult. But otherwise, it's our space, and if the police leave, it means we're, heating, cooling, whatever, this building for, 20 to 25 hours a week. Just a comment.
Now, if we were to renovate downstairs, we also have to consider where are we going to go during that time.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah, which is a huge logistical issue. It is even when you're thinking of
logistical and cost issues.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
That's probably on the low end.
Yeah.
The advantage, if we could figure out the parking problem, is that, it restores, what is a historic building to maybe fuller use, for the year doing that.
but even if they're renovated downstairs, they still don't have the square footage they need, which is recommended. They don't have the men's, women, juvenile, they physically can't get that square footage.
Right, but if we're thinking of renovating, Jody, I mean, we, you know, we'd be making use of, I'm thinking we'd be making use of this board as well. So they, we just come up here, you know, the town goes up there. It's not, you know, there's a lot of steps there. And I'm not saying I advocate, I'm just saying, you know, that was the idea, in my idea was, okay, we've got a lot of space here, we're not using it all. In some cases, because we can't, because there are structural issues and whatever the issues are, and access, you know, elevators, things, front entrance.
Right.
And on and on and on.
And how do we fix the water once and for all, should we say?
Right, right.
Is that water?
Well, I think that would say, that would be that, this beer.
That would be why, you know, it would be a complete renovation, so then we would do what we were planning on doing, not necessarily rebuilding there. So you could just, you know, demolish down there, put the drains, all that sand, close it back up, but the police wouldn't be there unless they were, you know, it'd be storage for all of us or whatever, you know. It's, the only reason that it's attractive is here we are, you know, here we are, and, you know, but parking, the lack of parking is, for me, the thing I always come back to as a challenge with this building that, you know, if we're gonna either increase the usage or whatever, we have to figure out how to do the parking.
Judy, that's actually the...
Yes, I just saw that, thank you. Thank you very much. We took them out of order.
Oh, Rollins Road is number two.
Thank you.
Do you think that the town would give up this building to a developer that wanted to develop it or something? So the long term, say you started with a police station and at some point you built a separate town hall, or say when you go to Silver Sheep, but went to maybe Turfback Field or whatever, then at some point you'd be able to attach on to us or something along that line. I guess, what's the really long-term plan for this building? Do you just keep sinking money until you know it's going to be a big white elephant forever and whatnot? Or do we want to be out of here and have a more cost-effective, space-efficient building?
It's a valid question. And it's not that it's unrelated to the police. I mean, obviously it's
all
unrelated. Years,
yeah.
But we may not be able to solve that one. We may not be able to solve both of those at the same time, or even think about the solution to those. Oh, but to the extent that it's helpful for us to think through, I mean, when I come down to, if the police are not here in this building, you know, we are heating, cooling, maintaining, whatever, for...
4 hours a day.
4 hours a day, and meetings.
Occasional meetings,
Can we consider moving the library downstairs? Because right now we're paying rent to the mill.
Well, one issue, it may work better upstairs, right? But that would be something...
Gets more people in the building.
Exactly. So if the police are not here, that provides another reason maybe to renovate the building at some point.
But you're getting rid of us because of the problems downstairs, and you're throwing someone else in there, and they're going to have some problems.
I didn't say downstairs. I wouldn't put anybody there. I wouldn't put anybody. It's a big, I mean, it's, you know, and I'm sorry you're there, but
you're right, you're the nervous
one. When we're trying to get you out of there. So,
if we stay, I want to just for a quick Silver Street question, can we add on town municipal at that site?
I don't think to have sufficient parking, no.
Even if it's a second floor with an elevator?
Well, when you're talking elevators, then you're talking a considerable cost.
Yeah, no, an elevator
up to
without.
And it can be done, sure. I mean, you could have this square size, this square footed building over there and be two or three stories, no doubt about it. But then, of course, you're talking about elevators.
It might work.
Cost.
It might work more that has a fire station now. Yeah. You know, just because we have smaller, you know, the town has smaller needs, I think. I'm not sure. But anyway.
No, something to think down the road. I have designed our building so that we have a larger conference training break room, so that if space was, extra space was needed, then certainly the town would have elections there because we'd be playing parking, whatever the case might be. If we had a larger town meeting for some reason, didn't need the full requirement of grade school, I mean, you could certainly, you know, move your operation to there if you needed a room bigger than this.
So it's like an intermediate size between this and the gymnasium?
Correct.
That's very attractive.
And the plan was to make it a community room so that, you know, the Boy Scouts, or the library group, or, you know, the...
Softball meeting.
Whoever wanted to be able to use it would have access to the building.
That's a great idea.
Great school.
I'm ready to talk about Collins Road. It's turned out to be number two. I mean, I think what makes that attractive is that it's a nice flat field.
It's flat, it's open, it's big.
It's big, it could.
We could put a police station there now and later on do something if we wanted to or had to.
Yeah, we could put town hall there as well.
And septic and water isn't an issue because there's plenty of space for a well and a septic.
So that's what's attractive about that.
But having said that, you have to purchase that, we're right across the street. You have the Turcot field, and it's much larger. Yeah, so instead of going over the old path and taking a left into the Porta field, talking about, you know, you take the right, so you go to the Turcot field. So I would think that the Turcot field would probably be a little bit higher than the Rollins Road, some of those road parts. I think you don't have to purchase it, you already own it.
Yeah,
and that's level and flat. Right, I didn't give it any thought because that, again, I'm thinking.
I mean, it does make.
But now as we thought, I think long term, if the town wants to get out of here, that certainly allows at some point the town hall to marry up to the police station if it's there. It can't do it on sewage, there's not enough land there. However, if you went to the Turcot field, then certainly, you know, 10 years on the road or whatever the case might be, there should be sufficient room for the town hall to go next door, or the fire department, whatever the case might be.
So can we put Turcot Field back on the list to consider them?
You gotta go which dots up.
I have a third dot for things we didn't want to lose sight of. So can we do it to Turcot Field?
I do too.
Purple. Yeah, Jody. Oh, you also?
Sure.
Put you both on, all right. Thank you.
I mean, it's true, it is the town. Town owns it. That makes it attractive. It gives us a stepped approach. You know, the police have the pressing need right now, but there would be enough space for us somewhere down the road for future boards to, and future towns to decide on that. Make some remarks about the post office. I was interested in that because, first of all, it's right across the street. And if had it been owned by the post office, the land and building, it might have been something we could work with our congressional delegation to try to figure something out. It turns out it's not the federal government or the USPS, whatever, is leasing it. So it makes it less, you know, sort of a less viable option, unless there are ways we can still work with our congressional delegation to do it. But that was the only reason they didn't want to take it off the list entirely. It provides some kind of potential advantage for trying to stay here. But there's still all kinds of, it's not clear cut. It's not a clear cut.
I'm not sure that it would be big enough to include parking as well.
Mm-hmm.
I'd make a heck of, tear it down, make a heck of parking lot for you folks.
Yeah.
But to put us across there, I just don't think.
As a whole, it would fit.
Yeah, I don't think it would fit.
Perhaps as a town hall, and then the police here. Yeah, I'm not trying to sell it, that was just, I did want to say why I had been thinking about that, and maybe it could work. And some of these other ideas seem more attractive, but that was my rationale for that.
Let's move on, if there are any comments on the fire station add-ons. We have that, and then we'll go back to Turcot for a little bit.
Are we allowed to buy the baseball field back from the library, or from the cemetery? That cemetery, right?
Well, you know, a lot of these things have challenges, right? So one of the things that one could do is figure out, you could do a land swap. I don't know, if you said to the cemetery, okay, we'd like to take this.
Okay.
And we can.
Give another piece of.
Here, buy it somewhere else, or maybe see if DL, what about it on the other side, DL? See if we can buy some of that. I mean, it's not that there aren't challenges, or, you know, it's pretty made. You know, what's attractive about some of these others, like Silver Street, is that some of these, I'll call them shenanigans, not really shenanigans, some of these, there aren't as many upfront challenges before you even get to a building. You know, at Silver Street, we'll get to the building pretty much right away. If the land is sized correctly, you say it is.
Does the fire department need that land possibly down the road for their own needs?
That's a really good question. I mean, you know, they're going to.
Because they're already talking about needing more room.
Yeah, space needs. Yeah, that's a really good point. Yeah, good point.
And my only concern about moving there is the train. You know, since I've been chief, we've had two major freight train derailments between the fire station and where we're the greenhouse. The train goes through here generally no faster than 27 miles an hour. So when it jumps the track, it's not going to go very far. However, we get Amtrak going through at 70 miles an hour. And if something happens, those cars are going to go flying. And there's always the potential that you could wipe out the fire station, the police station being that close to the tracks over there.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Feel free now to add in, I'll try to bounce back around, anything else on Turcot Fields, for instance, too. We don't have a lot on there except that.
I'll just add, only because I heard Ed Jansen mention it, that, and I don't know if it's true, but apparently the rationale that was made at the time for buying it is that it might be suitable for a new school. That was, I'm not saying anything other than what I've heard. Not advocating and not advocating, and just to add context to some of these.
Turcot. It would be suitable for that type of building, so obviously suitable for safety complex slash town hall, whatever, for the future.
It has, I don't know what the size, I was just writing it off the top of my head, but maybe 4 acres is new. Part of it. We don't have any budget on to repaint the wall, I'm saying.
Richard will have to volunteer, times are free.
Okay.
So can I just say something about Nesmond Field? It's my dot that says I don't want it to go away. So again, just mostly just to provide context for this board or future boards or anyone else to think about. I did talk to Mr. Nesmond about that a couple of years ago. It's a really large tract of land, 20-some odd acres. And so the challenge for that would be, and he at the time would sell it as whole. So the challenge then is whether the town could buy something like that and then itself sort of sell it off. So I have no idea about whether that's something we could do statute-wise or anything, but that's the challenge with the Nesmond Field, is that it's too big. way too big, so we have to figure out how to
do that. That one, sure.
Yeah. It's off Portland and General John. Is that, do I have that somewhere around there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I don't know that.
It was cost prohibitive when we looked at the first time.
Well, as a whole.
You only wanted to sell it as one parcel.
Right, so as a whole, yes. And so you see the challenge. I mean, you'd have to get the town or all of us to agree we're going to do that and then try to sell it off. And maybe you can sell it off such that you could help pay whatever you want to do. No guarantees, but.
Time, including John on this one, and then based on how you all feel, we'll open up to the public at that point.
But
let's give one more chance for these folks to go around, and then they'll have a chance after the public as well. Did anything on any of these that you'd like to make a comment on, an additional comment or thought? If you can't read my writing, please ask what I've written.
Is there a plan in place to get rid of the old building on Silver Street?
Yes and no.
There was a gentleman that was interested in tearing it down and using it for metal for whatever he needed it for. So there was a bid out, but he never responded. Since then, I'm remaking the bid. We found out there was more interest, and we found out it would cost about $6,000 to tear it down and move it ourselves. So I put in I didn't put in a minimum bid because they're going to take it away from us. Great.
Yeah,
save us some money. Because we checked with fire, police, and everybody that no one needed it. So it's going to go out to bid again this week. And I did find that there was 4 or 5 other people that are interested in that because it's very easy to house your livestock or whatever because it just comes apart and goes back.
Yeah, and this board worked at edging it out for the last 2 or 3 years. And so there are no more vehicles or...
Right now there's sandbags and a trailer.
What is there?
Sandbags and a trailer.
A trailer.
When did the trailer show up?
A few years ago. It was military surplus.
We're getting a little off. We're getting a little off track here, folks.
All right.
Okay. Let's try to speak to what we're doing here.
The Silver Street location does have an existing water. I'm not. Does Becaris Drive have sewer, or are they doing this?
I think that was a conversation. We have to run a line from.
I'm just wondering if we went out the back towards Becaris Drive for sewer.
Existing town water, correct?
Correct, town water, yeah. So
we can talk about that a couple of years ago. I don't remember. I think
where there is no water, Friday, Rollins Road,
correct.
Summers Road,
correct. Right.
Correct. So,
okay. Yeah. Or Turcotte.
Anyone else comments on anything there? And it does look like 1 and 2 are remain 1 and 2. I see that no changes come from discussion.
Number 2 being Rollins Road. Right?
Rollins Road and Summersworth. Yeah. Rollins Road, Silver Street. So at this point, we'll open it up for thoughts, comments from. Billering.
I don't know how this is going to go over, probably not well, but have we considered outsourcing the police function? And I believe if we're going to look at this, that's something we need to look at, is that an option for the town? To contract with another agency for law enforcement services. Is that something we want to do? Is it something that can be done? I don't know. But I think it should be part of the discussion, at least that we consider it as part of our due diligence for this project.
Well, several of you know that I've mentioned that. And I do support looking at this, if only to say, no, we do want to have our own local force it. It would either reconfirm, revalidate, or whatever. But, you know, my argument.
And once again, if we could hold the arguments till we get all the input, just a discussion, or we can decide if we're going to discuss that. Let's get ideas and input first.
Where is Turcotte Field?
It's, do you know where Greenview, the recycle, oil recycling? So
okay, over by the overpass.
Yeah, it's kind of like
okay.
Out there, to the left, if you continue.
Where they plant the corn.
Yes, that's it.
Okay.
Exactly right. Kim?
One of the ideas that Berwick and Southbrook are doing right now is sharing a facility. They're looking into a shared facility. Have we investigated that at all?
I would just put it up as a
shared as in with other communities or just shared within the
community? They're building a space together.
Okay.
I don't know if that's something that we could investigate.
I think it's a good idea. I mean, I think in general it's a good idea if you don't think about those.
Regional services.
Yes.
And if you have comments on other things that have, you know, if you want to add comments to any of the other options up there too.
Yeah. Is there, so you mentioned potentially adding on to the fire station. Is there a reason that the police couldn't go to Silver and then down the road, if needed or when needed, the town hall could not be added on to the fire station?
I think we mentioned that.
It was mentioned.
We did mention that at some point as a possibility, and that's what prompted someone to say the fire may be needing extra space for themselves down the road. But that's also a possibility.
Sorry, I'm always the one with all the questions. Why is there not more interest in the Turcotte Field if we already own it?
I think some of that's been brought up, but and we'll wait for discussion until other people get things. I will make note of it.
Can you speak about your, I'm in favor of the Silver Street option instead of putting more money in this building, that's for sure. I mean, we put a ton of money, this 20 years ago, to put another 650 that was mentioned. I'm very much against that, about renovating this building again. I just think it's just adding more money, putting more money into another building. I understand the building, I understand it's historical value and all that, but to spend more money on this, if it was done 20 years ago the right way, we wouldn't be here talking today, but that's neither here nor there now. But
thank you, that's a good comment, this is not thank you, that's a good comment for everyone to hear. So, good. So another hand right there?
No, I was just going to say the same thing.
Me too.
Move out of here.
I will make a note. Somebody said don't do more to this building.
I'm going to ask a question of one of the public's about it. Do you want
to? I think we have time. We'll give it another 4 or 5 minutes.
Okay. So, Kim, with regard to Turcotte Field, does it rank higher in your mind than Silver Street? I mean, we own both, so I'm curious just to get more feedback from you on Turcotte Field.
I think my two top choices would be Turcotte Field. I like the idea of potentially doing the police department now, and then having the ability to build on Town Hall later. Alternatively, Silver Street, with the, if we had the ability to add onto the fire station for Town Hall is attractive. They're, I think they're both attractive options.
So this is really a comment, if I'm allowed to.
This is sort of a discussion topic.
So the thing that distinguishes Turcotte Field from Silver Street, you know, that Kim just illustrated, I think, is the expandability. So if we were to put the police station on Silver Street, we feel there's room now, and I think Chief feels that there's room to grow the police station, but there's not room for another facility. It won't be a public safety building, it can't be the police and Town Hall. So Turcotte Field allows us to put the police there, and it allows us at some point to think about expanding with the Town Hall, but we don't have to do it right away, so we can sit back and, you know, take a breather from big projects.
It's not in your nature.
The building on Silver Street would preclude us from, in the future, if we decided to build a Town Hall at Turcotte Field. The idea of Silver Street is attractive to me because it's visible.
That's a good point. That's actually a good point, Judy, I think. The visibility.
But
the Turcotte Field is very attractive because of the expansion potential, but as I said, it wouldn't preclude us from building there anyway. So.
As a Town Hall, but I mean, we would.
And there's nothing that they have to be next to each other anyway.
Gentleman behind Bill first.
The Silver Street, what about the abutters? And it's a residential area. Do you think there would be some problems with that? I would if I was, I'm close to it. I live close to the area. But all of a sudden, if I had a big RA structure put in that area, I would be, especially the new house that was just built, I mean, I just feel that it would have some effect on the residents in that area.
It's a valid point.
Do we own the whole of that Turcotte Field?
Yeah, whatever it is, ports. I don't have the map in front, it's like 4 acres.
Pretty good size.
Yeah, VL only rents a part of it.
If Chief, is that too close to the tracks for your, I mean, that's...
Oh, definitely not. I mean...
Okay, so we could do something there. To me, that makes sense, rather than Silver Street, that we start there with the police, and then if we want to expand, I think as Kim said, then we could put Town Hall there and even fire if that came down the road. That would be, I think, a wonderful location for a municipal complex. And I would start it, and rather than go with two places, let's put it all together. I mean, if we own both pieces of property, I think the Turcotte Field has that availability there. We have water there, but not sewer.
We do have water there?
No.
It's on Silver Street.
We have no water and no sewer there.
Okay. Yeah, that was
fair enough. Silver Street, we have water.
Right.
Sewer.
So we have
but that's
to
not
that
far. Because, we have to get around the tracks. Thank you.
Can I just ask for Bob's feedback on Turcotte Field?
So what was the question?
What's your feedback on Turcotte Field?
Certainly in the long run, if the plan is to save some money for the town folks in the long run by having one large complex, and we'll certainly do that, than having several other buildings, then I don't see that there's any disadvantage for us to go into the Turcotte Field.
Is there a reason you preferred Silver over Turcotte?
We had been looking at Silver Street for a number of years, and until today I didn't realize that the Turcotte Field was an option. But having said that, listening to everybody today, and knowing that there might be the possibility of future expansion for other services, then maybe a Turcotte field is better suited than the Sewell Street property. Like I said, you know, if we build the larger conference slash training break room, whatever, for our training and need purposes, whatnot, and then next door goes a town hall, then you're not building another large meeting room for the town folks. I mean, you have one large room for all purposes.
If I could get some clarity, I think what I'm hearing you're saying, and I just want to make sure, because I don't know if I should write this down or not, is the initial cost would be a little bit higher than Silver, would be higher than Silver Street, because we'll have to do water and sewer and
utilities.
Water and utilities, but in the long run, it would probably be, so the initial cost would be a little bit higher than going to Silver Street. Am I hearing that correctly?
I think so, yeah.
I mean, once we put that police station on Silver Street, I mean, it's there. I mean,
right, it's there.
It's there. So, and it's hard to repurpose something that was designed as a police station, I think. So Judy, how do we, from a process point of view, if there seems to be,
we're going to get there in just a second.
Can I speak real quick to the
yes.
outsourcing and the shared facility?
Yes.
Just keep in mind, if you're considering outsourcing police, most of these agencies like Dover and Somersworth, they're not going to want to take on Rollinsburg. Stratford Sheriff doesn't have a night shift, a midnight shift. They are strictly civil, and they do ICE, and they do New Hampshire and Maine Marshals. So they basically are Monday through Friday, 8 to 4. If you're considering state police, think about Lebanon, Maine. Residents will tell you they wait hours for either York County or Maine State Police to show up. We have the same problem. We don't know where New Hampshire troopers are going to be at any time when a call comes in. If you're talking about the midnight shift, they may have one car out the Hampton Mass line on 95, and that's your closest police officer that come to the town. As far as shared facilities with another community, Dover just got a brand new state-of-the-art building, so I'm sure they don't want us moving in. Somersworth just got their new PD 2-3 years ago, so that's really not a viable option. As far as Maine, now you have a problem with Maine, New Hampshire. You can't, they're totally different states, totally different certifications. Mm-hmm. If you arrest someone in Rollinsford, you can't bring them across the Maine line, and vice versa. There's state laws that prohibit that. So those are just things to think about when you're thinking of sharing with a different community and outsourcing.
I think those are really, they're all valid points. I think, you know, for me, you know, from a strictly financial point of view, I mean, I just look at the size of our community, the cost for us to provide these services ourselves, and how hard it is sometimes to keep staff and all this sort of thing. So it's just a natural, it's not just police. I mean, you could think about this for highway, for fire, for our services. How do we find ways to provide a level of service for the town that is proportional to us, I guess. And so it's just hard because you've got all these bigger cities and towns around us, and you know, sometimes it seems like we have fewer options. So, but I hear what you're saying, John, and I don't disagree. I just think we still, I mean, I do like to bring it up. I just like to, you know, make sure we don't lose sight. And so, because it's good to have these, to hear that.
Absolutely. Those are just my thoughts, though.
Yeah.
Plus, obviously, I love my job.
Nancy?
Now that we're hearing Turcotte Field, I believe that would be the better option. And in the long run, it might cost us more, but by moving the town offices, wouldn't it actually end up saving us because of the cost of running this building where it's only 4 hours a day? So I think in the long run, just adding the other building would end up being a cost savings.
Yeah, the note actually says higher upfront cost, but long term is probably a better thing. Kim was next.
Just a quick question about the shared facilities. You mentioned that they don't really probably, well, Dover and Somersworth don't want to share their facilities. First question is why. Second question is how much time do you guys actually spend in the facility?
The chief and I actually spend quite a bit doing all the administrative work. The guys are out on the road much more.
So.
And we're going to stop that discussion right now. It's out of the scope of what we're trying to do here today. I mean, if it's something to be investigated, we will, it'll be up there. And then there was another hand up.
What happens to this building if we proceed to this Turcotte Field business? What happens to this building in general?
So I'll make a note of that.
I have a suggestion. So.
When we're doing that, Judy, I just want to make sure people know where Turcotte Field is, because I'm not sure we described it correctly.
I know exactly where it is.
Okay, it's not the cornfields that you see right away. You have to go beyond the recycle place, and then it's over on the left.
Oh, to beyond this, so you have to access that through that road.
Yes, we're through.
Yes, so you can't actually drive towards it today. You kind of have to park. There's a red gate.
Yeah.
So, but it's right beyond that red gate on the left.
Okay, I'm familiar with that area.
That's Turcotte Field. I thought maybe we were on the wrong side of the.
I was thinking of the one right
on
the track.
He does corn there as well.
Well, actually, that's what I thought too. That area to the right there was way.
Who owns that?
It's. Used to have a.
Now you're talking considerable cost to build a road out there.
Oh yes, no water, no road. That's a good one. Yeah, but still. Yeah, so they're, more upfront costs.
Right, it's just to the left of where the Boy Scouts used to camp years ago.
So far out now, you're going nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
You have to read about the whole area, as far as roads.
You're right, that's well out of sight.
Well out of sight. It's way, way out of sight. All right, so I'm going to, we're at 10 past the hour. I'll give everyone sort of a moment. It'll take a quick minute break or two so people can think if they have some final comments, and then we will start talking about next steps. So take a two-minute break. Think you want to have a final comment.
Right. From that on Greenfield Road, where that building is, if you go back farther, across from Scoutland.
It's a nice walking path up there. It owns the land where the
I think he owns the rest of that too. Should
the same maybe the rent?
Well, I think yes, that could well be.
Maybe that would be it.
Oh, yeah, we got an email from you.
Yes.
You see that intersection of Scoutland?
Okay.
To the
left.
Yes.
It's actually before you get to the
actual. Yeah, if you went
it's kind of like in between.
Right. And if you went down there, you know, when you go into Scoutland through that gate there,
you come from Summersworth.
You'd have to go through the gate. And then
you'd
have to
go right
across
from
Summersworth. From the Summersworth Road, or if you go down Greenfield.
Everyone really knows where Turcotte Field is and all that stuff up in Lascaux. So first from the public, any last thoughts that you want to share at this moment? Kim?
It's not more of a question. Is Turcotte Field accessible to Main Street Summersworth?
No, I don't think what so. The old railroad tracks end up going out to on that Summersworth Road, not quite to a side road and then to Summersworth Road, but I don't.
You go down Old Indigo.
Old Indigo.
Right where it's at, and that's at the town line and city line, and then down Scoutland Road. So yes, it could be acceptable that way. You're still changing.
We're not to get into too much discussion because it can be added on, but one more thing.
Well, just I'm just trying to determine the factors that make it more attractive. Is it possible to bring water in over there?
So that's something to so basically, if I'm hearing you correctly, you're saying consider looking at it from the Summersworth side, if need be, right? So. Just a little story. My parents moved to Virginia and found out that they moved from New England, and they found out that there really wasn't a local fire number to call. If their house were on fire, they had to call the county. They didn't know how to call the county. Luckily, their house was never on fire. They were really happy about that. But what there was no visible fire station and no visible police station. And it ended up being very, very interesting for them to move out of New England where they could see everybody doing that. So consider access from Somersworth. So in order to get to the Rollinsford Police Department, please go through Somersworth. I was just thinking of the signage that we have. I'm sorry, it was just amusing. but consider that. Other public thoughts? Bill?
We need to get the police out of the basement as soon as possible.
Hello.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Any other public comments? All right, then back to our panel. And John, you're part of that.
Ditto.
I see both Chief Ducharme and Suzanne want to speak.
Well, I was just going to say, it seems that I wanted to, the existing space, number three, I'd like to ask the panel if we think we can just put that one aside.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, and I'm wondering if, if it's Silver Street, Rollins Road, and in my mind, Turcotte Field is kind of like, our number three. And, there's the possibility, maybe we sell Turcotte Field to buy Rollins Road, or, so they're, I see them as somewhat, they provide the same kinds of advantages. The real difference is that one is more visible and accessible, because it's right on Rollins Road. The other one we own, but it's kind of far back. So if there's some way to sort of, I'd like to not lose sight of Turcotte Field. I would like not to lose sight of Rollins Road.
I think it's fine to wipe off existing space.
The old Porter. Do you remember when the Porters used to have a little convenience store?
Other panel on there?
I agree.
Okay, by Peasley. It's by Peasley. It's next to Peasley.
And
okay, let me think. You know about that.
Came off and sort of
two A.
I see them.
Luckily, they're on the same sheet as paper. Isn't that interesting? Didn't that work out really well? So we'll just
before the overpass.
We'll get the railroad tracks up there.
Oh
yeah. That's right. Yes, I wanted to put them in. Other final thoughts from the board before we move on to next steps and timeline. All right, then we are moving on. All right, we can take this down entirely. Now there is number four on this, which is the cemetery and availability, so we can talk about next.
Yeah, we're not going to get rid of it.
We're not going to get rid of that, but we'll just put it here. All right. All right, so next steps here. Next steps and timeline. You go. If I was pulling the paint off.
Possibly.
Yeah, that makes sense. Maybe that's sticky, one never knows. All right. And I'm really not sure right now which works best, but maybe we should start talking timeline. And that, so one is going to inform the other, I think, in some way. So if we can talk timeline, sort of ideal timeline, and then talk about next steps for that. I think so. Making sure we don't lose sight of anything we want to do. So
I don't know about timeline, and it's probably not a good idea to talk to me personally about timeline right now because I'm sort of awash. But from a next step, isn't the next step to take a look at our top two or three items and at least develop sort of like some of the gross cost or the gross cost benefit analysis?
Well, that's next steps. Let's talk about next steps and make timeline one of the next steps and then prioritize them. Let's talk about next steps altogether, then prioritize them. I think that makes sense. Does that make sense to most people on the panel?
Yeah.
By timeline, you don't mean a timeline for an entire project, right?
Mm-hmm.
No. When's we're going to do
the next step? Okay.
I think it's from what I'm gathering from people, I think it's important to have an idea of an end time, whether it's a year from now, 2 years from now, mm-hmm. whatever it is. right now, we're going to talk about next steps and timeline will be, I believe, one of them, if you guys say so. So. Okay. And then we will prioritize those. I heard you, so there was a thing about gross costs for
yeah,
options
some,
one and two.
Yeah, or a list of what has to, the challenges, you know, so that we can start to collect an idea of the overall cost.
We want to form the committee that will involve the public.
Right, form the committee and have the committee tasked with evaluating and maybe doing a walkthrough of the Silver Street, Rollins Road, and the Turcot Field, and then come back to us or whomever with some preliminary costs. What's needed at each location,
mm-hmm.
what's not needed.
So does that cover your idea of getting costs and things?
Yeah, I like the idea that a formed committee, we haven't formed yet, but I like the idea that the committee would do that.
And evaluate, we're talking now about evaluating the three locations essentially, correct?
That's
correct. So, and sort of, and so I'm not even going to say that. Silver Street, Rollins Road, I'm just going to call it Rollins. And Turcot Field, correct?
And of course, just so we all keep this in mind, Rollins Road is actively for sale.
Mm-hmm. Other next steps?
Determine a timeline for evaluating locations, coming up with some preliminary costs, and report back to the board.
Do you have an idea for when the committee might be able to accomplish that?
Yes,
well, some of the work is already started. So.
Pardon?
30 days? I mean, we have one rough idea as to what it may cost to do the building
yeah.
one way. Within a week or two, I should have a rough cost just to do it another way.
Yeah.
So we're really looking at, you know, like for the Turcot Field, the road, well, versus putting in either from Summersworth City Water or from Rollins or somehow getting underground,
yeah.
or things like that, water and sewer and
okay.
things like that. So those will really need to focus on both those cost figures.
Well, it's important to keep it moving. So if you take 30 days, that's great.
Wonderful.
Other next steps before we start deciding, you know, who's going to do it?
I think that's it. That's the next step.
There are no, okay.
I think in the meantime, we can probably work on the Silver Street property. You know, your plans to get rid of the building.
Mm-hmm.
The highway department has already offered to help us remove their old telephone poles they used to hang the snowplow equipment on, and we're going to actually transfer those telephone poles down to our range. So they've offered to help us there. There's actually an existing outbuilding, I think there are two small outbuildings in the back where they used to store salt and sand. There's no reason the highway department can't just knock those down and haul them down to the transfer station. So at least we're moving forward doing something, if not anything.
Yeah.
Even if we never go to Silver Street, at least we're cleaning up that
yeah,
piece of property.
Yeah, it could be available for sale.
And I wonder if in the study that you're doing for that piece of property, did they actually survey that property?
It seems, I don't know the answer to that. We've got a preliminary report from them that I think we put on the website. It's on our Google Drive, and if you remind me if I forget, I can point you to that.
I think
that.
They did.
Pardon?
No.
Preliminary?
Oh,
no. Survey, right, yeah. I'm
yeah.
not sure that surveying was part of what they were going to do. I think I agree
no.
with
you. Well, I did see some flags out there. Well, another thing that
we
might
the guy
do,
on the side, that he may have surveyed, I think he surveyed that line.
Yeah. We found one on the other side as well. They were fairly new, so that's what I was asking.
Yeah.
So, I'm just wondering, maybe also in the meantime, maybe contact someone like Paul Connolly and say, you know, would you be able to go out and survey that for us? You know, find out what the cost for that might be.
I would say Target and Mountain is...
Thank you.
We have found them to be a more reasonable, reasonable surveying cost. I'm just saying.
Mm-hmm.
But it accomplishes the same thing, the survey. We could ask, this group could ask Cardigan, we could ask Paul, mm-hmm. who would charge the survey. The board would have to determine this. I mean, it cost us $1,000.
Let's not...
All right, thank you.
Let's not get all... Again, let's try to get to the next steps without...
So, this is, I believe, on Target. So, I'd like the board's input on this as well as Chief Ducharme, but at some point in a more formal capacity, you know, we're going to want to invite the town into this process. So I'm wondering if perhaps with a report that outlines these three locations and options and, you know, pros and cons and whatnot, but that might not be a time for a public hearing.
Yes.
So, you know, that's just a possibility, you know, at the end of that. Okay. Do we want to take the step of forming the committee today? Well, I think we could. The board can talk about the makeup. You know, board members. How many board? You know, this sort of thing.
You mean right now or another time?
I think right. I don't know. Maybe we could toss out some ideas. You know, a board member. How many folks from the RPD would you like on that?
I'll grab myself a lieutenant.
Okay. Are there other officials that Mike and Jody that should be part of this planning or conservation? I don't know. Or
someone from the planning board should probably be involved.
Okay. And then how many? Than just general public. So what do we think would be a good number?
Preferably the general public and then general public with building expertise in public. Because we have a lot of people in town that are licensed septic designers, licensed builders, mm-hmm. licensed well builders.
So I was saying we want someone from the building trades. So one member of the public on the building trades.
We can solicit. We can use the one to solicit.
One retired police officer, I would think. There are a number of retired police officers in this town who may be able to offer some expertise. So
we'll get them all down and you can decide.
But that would be our public member.
What about the budget committee?
Mm-hmm.
The budget committee really needs to have an official presence.
That should be above
yeah,
with
right.
the planning board member.
Yeah. So now we're up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I will tell you from very recent experience, if we get too much bigger, it's going to be very, very difficult to get people to be able to meet and move forward.
Mm-hmm.
How does this, how does this look? I'm not as, attracted to a retired police officer. I mean, I think just general public. Yeah. I mean, I think if we could get a solid building trades person, and maybe just really interested general public, or a second building trade. I mean, one or the other. But
The retired public safety person, I would assume police officer. May be able to, will certainly be able to offer a different perspective than someone from the building trades or someone from the general public. I think there should be one other member from the general public, unaffiliated, to be honest with you. And they may offer different opinions than the current members of the Rollinsford Police Department. I value the members of the Rollinsford Police Department's opinions most definitely. What I'm saying is that the retired police officer from a different community can offer different experiences that our officers may not have had.
From somewhere else. That's what you're saying.
Yes. I'm not asking for a retired Rollinsford police officer.
Well, one of the things we could do is, if we solicit, is say that we are looking for folks with building trade experience or retired public safety, mm-hmm. or, very interested for whatever reason.
So essentially we're saying too public. So that we have that. And hoping for one planning board member, one budget committee member, one select board member. So here we still have, so we have one, two, three, four, five, so seven. That's still a seven. All right, do we want to put names next to them? We know here it's the chief and the lieutenant, correct?
I'm interested in serving.
From the planning board or from the board?
From the board.
I'm sorry?
I'm interested in serving.
Well, we should probably...
Well, we'll do the formal appointment in a meeting, but we're asking...
I think we'll do the board appointment at a board meeting, and then we can...
Mm-hmm. We'll do all of them at a...
Correct.
All right, so let's make sure that we do have the next steps for this happening.
Someone needs to draft something to put on the website to get interested folks and post.
Right.
Post for public, right?
Yes.
And how are you going to go about getting the planning board and the budget committee member?
We can ask, the planning board is currently meeting. The budget committee is not scheduled to meet until the end of April. So it kind of depends on when that 30-day window starts, I guess.
You do have a member of the retired police and budget committee sitting in this room. Not to throw him under the bus.
Agreed.
We have several budget committee people here, too.
Do we?
But the budget committee should probably, as a committee, make that decision.
Yes.
They can.
One, two, three, four.
Well, the planning board has already met for April, correct?
Yeah.
So they're not till May.
The budget committee meeting's in a couple of weeks.
I don't know if that's too late. It goes to timeline, that's why it's up.
Well, so if we plan to get the group together by the beginning of May, and then we get a report by the beginning of June.
Correct.
Does that work?
I think that works.
So this is time to assemble.
No, we can't. No.
Well, you're saying yes, she's saying no.
Monday, the board can work on this new draft.
You can't do any email communications and consider it a committee meeting.
On the website.
You can't call it a meeting.
We can call a meeting, but we can't communicate.
So let's say that they, does anyone have a calendar in front of them? Because essentially we want this group ready to convene maybe the first week in May. We can go that far at this point. Is that what people are thinking? First week?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Four weeks from now, yeah.
May 1st is on Monday.
Mm-hmm. So that the group would be constituted by the first week in May for the committee. First week in May, committee meets. So
if we could shoot to get the report on either June 5th or June 12th. Okay. I won't be here on June 5th, but I don't think I can not support the report. I will be here on June 12th.
So June 5 to the 12th. Are those the Mondays?
Those are Mondays, yes.
Okay. 5th or 12th, report to select board, correct?
Mm-hmm. And then we could would we want to hold a public hearing sort of like kind of reasonably soon after that? Because I suppose it depends on how complete that report is. So I guess we don't have to...
No, I think we,
you want to set up?
I would say if you want to think to try to get that out as soon as possible, well, okay.
So, well, if the report is done on the 12th, then you could hold a public hearing like a week of the 19th. And then we have to see what the tenor of people is, the tenor of the town, the tenor of the officials, the tenor of the building committee. So I don't know that I can take it beyond that. Okay. Again, I'm going to leave this up to you all to think about for just a little bit. Again, from recent experience, we'll need to have a sort of chair of the committee, so that someone is responsible for making sure that things happen and happen on time. We need to put a name next to it.
Right now?
No.
Well, the committee can make that decision if they wish. We know two people. All right. I believe we have actually, we've got a short timeline that gets us up as far, hopefully, at the public hearing. I believe we have addressed our goals. We have somewhat decided, somewhat laid out what the committee's going to do. Evaluate the locations, come up with preliminary costs. Is there anything else that they are going to be charged with?
Identifying firms that can handle both the design and construction would be helpful.
Well, part of that is going to be getting the preliminary costs, though, isn't it?
Well,
so,
perhaps.
So, okay, but ID professionals to help or whatever. To provide services? You're talking about getting surveys and things, or?
Well, part of the preliminary cost would be vetting some of the professionals that would be providing some of the services. So vetting first and then coming up with the preliminary cost.
So sort of recommend.
I guess I don't see that happening right there.
You
know? No, I mean, because we're looking for some of the big picture issues with each particular site and not so much with this architecture design. You know, if you've got a preliminary cost for a building, it's going to be that cost plus whatever the, you know.
Well, we have one already. We're confident that that's the
No, but Bob said he's getting another one.
For a different style of design build.
Yeah, okay.
John?
But I think most of that revolves around Silver Street, so I understand where Selectman Rolla is going. Are you talking more about the road, the water, the sewage,
yes,
things like that?
Whole host of things that we need to go into the other options. So.
Well, part of it is identifying all of those things, right? So that's the evaluation. That I see that as the large evaluation of the sites. So maybe
Mike and I are different spots. So what I'm thinking happens after like the public hearing is that there's some sort of general consensus around one of these. Now, maybe it won't happen. Once there's a general consensus around one of these, then you sort of go into, okay, now how do we refine what needs to get done? You know, then you get down to how to manage that part of the project.
I'm writing this down here because only because thinking as a member of the public, it would be hard for me to evaluate them if I don't have an idea of the preliminary costs, meaning, yeah, we have to build a road, we have to do this, we have to do that. So we are expecting preliminary costs, which I think goes back to Mike's point of the committee itself can't spend the town's money, so they may be coming to the select board saying, we need to get this, you know, we need to get someone to give us an estimate on building a road, right? Was that more where you were at? But that will happen in this time frame.
Very ambitious.
And that's our villagers who come in.
Yes.
Some of our villagers people can say, oh, you have a
50-foot road to build that 50 feet wide, it's going to cost you this amount. And they can pop it, do it off the top of their head, and then factor in the current cost of asphalt.
So again, I mean, I think we're looking for the gross contours of the projects, you know, as well as a list of some of the pros and cons, et cetera. And not, you know, so, you know, ballpark.
Yeah, good ballpark.
Sort of,
good ballpark, yeah.
I'm going to write down magnitude-wise. So is this large, is this small, is this one bigger than that one? Is that one smaller than this one? So that they get ranked sort of in that preliminary cost kind of thing. So think about it. But anyway, that'll be sort of up to the committee and what they can do. So let me just double, so anything further? So the follow-on would be to take the public input and then move forward with whatever the public input.
With how the public input and the input of the committee and the board and the, but, you know, hopefully there's, you know, we've arrived at some kind of consensus. If we haven't, that's going to be another issue.
Thoughts? You've done some remarkable work here today, people, I think.
And thank you.
Got all down to your goals. I'm available. No.
Yeah, you're on speed dial.
If needed.
I'm going to take that down because everything else is on those sheets that we'll take that.
I was just going to take a picture of it.
Oh, perfect.
I'll be providing notes just of the I'm not going to make notes of all the little things we said about options we've ruled out, but I will make sure there's a list of them. All right. Thank you all very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming, everybody.
Yes.
Thank you. Nice to see the support. Appreciate it.
Judy, very good job.
Thank you very much.